Samsung S21 Plus is an awesome phone that after using it for a little bit over a month, here is the things I gotta say about it. By no means, this is going to be an official review since we're still getting the updates for fixing and tweaking the software. So by the time you guys get this phone in your hand, it's gonna be probably a little bit different. But I'm gonna tell you this, this is going to be probably that best phone of 2021. Even though that is not a final product, when you hold it in your hands, it gives you that premium feeling. So I hope that they make it on this color, because honestly, I'm not a big fan of the glossy finish. But let's talk about the screen. Basically, the whole phone is a screen. There are barely bezels on this phone. You get a camera on the front for face recognition that works pretty well. You get a fingerprint scanner under the screen that I'm not a big fan of it, but it does what it's supposed to. The camera module on the back has been redesigned, it's protected, so it's gonna be hard for you to crack that lens. Not like the previous model, the S20 and the old models that it was so easy to crack them. This is not gonna be happening on this phone. What do you get with this new module? Well, it's a triple camera with a 1264 and 12 megapixel with a 3x optical zoom for objects over 100 feet away that is gonna make it look like it's 3 feet away. Well, after a whole day of taking pictures with the Samsung 21 Plus and the iPhone 12 Pro Max, here are some sample of pictures that I took with both phones, and there you're gonna be able to see who is taking the better phone, which one is the one that you want for you. Mind you, this is not, at least on the Samsung S21 Plus, there are still some tweaks that they're doing on the camera with the software. So we just received an update not too long ago. I haven't been able to update the phone, because I've been playing with the other phones that I just got. So let's keep talking about what powers this phone. It comes with an 8 GB of RAM. It comes in two sizes, 128 GB, 256 GB. It comes with Android 11 out of the box, 5G, of course, and you know, the new Snapdragon 888. Performance has been very good, and I have to admit, I'm impressed with the phone and the battery. Oh my god, the battery, it lasts me through the whole day. I mean, last time I had a phone like this, it was the Mate 20 Pro. That, as you guys know, that phone is a beast when it comes about battery life. I'm telling you guys, this phone right here, I mean, through the whole day, without no problem. Well, so here it is. After using the phone for a little bit over a month, I have to say I'm a little bit impressed how the phone performs. It's very quick, it's very snappy, it takes very good pictures, that it's gonna be getting better and better with the new updates that they're releasing. They have this huge 4800 milliamp hours battery that will easily hold you through the 8 hours of day, at least with my usage. And I have to admit, Samsung has come a long way since Note 7, and it looks like it's getting better and better by the day. Like I say, this is not a final product, this is not an official review. When this phone gets released, you will be able to get a more refined, a better product than what I'm showing you today. So it's time for me to put this phone back in the box. And guys, I tell you, the Samsung Fold 3 is crazy. I've been playing with it for a week now, and I mean, the numbers are crazy. That's the only thing I gotta say about it. So if you guys like the content of this video, you guys can support me at the Patreon. The link is on the description. If not, just like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.